the same password, but now in the next example, after locking the password, we are having an exclamation mark. It means that the account is locked. An account is locked when the password begins with this exclamation mark. If you can see the exclamation mark before the password hash, it means that the account is locked. And if you run that passwd-u gecko, the exclamation mark is removed, the account is unlocked again, gecko is able to use the password to log into the system. Okay, now the next topic. Status of a user account. The option dash capital S lists the status of the user account. You can view the status, you can check the status of the user account with the passwd program by using dash capital S option. Dash capital S option enables you to check the status of an account. This is by running the command passwd space dash capital S echo, we can check the status of account. But the status is, we'll study here. The status follows directly after the username. Okay. This is the username echo, and after that, right after that, we have the status. Right now we are having capital P, capital S. In the above example, LK locked means that the user is unable to log in. Okay? Other options are NP, no password, or PS, valid password. It means that we are having PS. PS means valid password. It means that the account is unlocked, that the account is active. The account has a valid password, which means that the user of that account can log in the system by using the password, because the password is valid. If there were LK, it means locked, the user is not able to use that password. The account is locked, it means. Okay, there are some more things you can see. They are followed by the date of the last password change. This is the date when the last password changed. The minimum length of the validity, the maximum length of the validity, and the warning period and inactivity period when the password was expired. This portion specifying the minimum validity time, the maximum validity time, or the maximum warning time. But here we are having minus 1, it means that we are disabling this feature. We are not using this feature because the expiry is null. This password will never expire. Changing password time. We have some specific time for passwords, for valid password, for invalid password. We have specific things for password, but we can do with them here. You can change the various password time by using the following options. These are the following options available with the password editing program to change the password times. First option is I number, dash I number. We can use dash I number. The I number can do disable an account after the password has been expired for a number of days. Suppose the password is expired and you are having dash I number set to 10. After the expiration of the password, after 10 days of expiration, the account is disabled. The 10 days is a period where the account can be retrieved. But after disabled, the account is lost. Dash N number sets the minimum number of days before a password can be changed. This is a specific number after which you can change the password. Before that N number, you cannot change the password. But after the N numbers, N days, dash N days, you can change the password. Suppose you change the password right now, and you again try to change it, it will not allow you to change the password, because it will wait for n days to span, and then it will allow you to change the password. This is the minimum limit for n. Dash w, this is the most important option, warns the user that in w number of days, his password will expire. You can set a warning for you before the expiry date of your account, that it will warn you some days before, whatever the W value is set. that you change your password. Dash X number sets the maximum number of days a password remains valid. This is the validity time of a password. After X number of days, the password must be changed. Whatever the value you set for X, after this date, this is the limit of your password validity. When the time of X passed and you try to use your password, it will prompt you to change the password. It will never allow you to log in. When you change the password, then it will allow you to log in again. Here we are having an example for this. So what the example is? Sir, by looking the options available, can you give me an idea what this possibility command is doing? A little bit idea, not sure. What do you think?
You're setting, making some settings for the password for username Gecko, and 5 days before the password expires, the user will get a warning, and email, and 30 days, this password will remain valid for 30 days.
Perfect. We are setting dash X 30. If we the expiry date for that account is 30 days. And after 25 days from today, the user Gecko have a message to the warning message, the W, the dash option W, enables a warning for you to change the password. So you're clear with that? In this example, the password, the above example which sir described, in this example, the password of the Gecko, user Gecko remains valid for 30 days. As I said, after this time, the password is required to be changed by Gecko or by the administrator. Gecko receives a warning 5 days before the password expiration. When the command possibility is used to establish or change the password for a user account, the file /etc/default/possibility is checked for the encryption method to be used. What possibility command do is to encrypt the password. And for encryption, we can use different type of techniques. We have multiple available techniques to encrypt the password. So possibility program will check that file. What encryption technique is assigned there? What encryption technique is set there? So possibility command will encrypt the password by using that alert. So
default is Glowfish.
Glowfish. So we'll go through that file. What this file contains? This is a description of the file. What this file contains? This file contains some information for the password possibility. Possibility command. This file contains information for possibility command. Path command and other tools creating or modifying password. If this file is not just for possibility program, if this file is for some other tools using to encrypt that, encrypt password. Possibility is not the only program use this file. There are some other programs which are using this file to encrypt passwords. Define default crypt hash. Crypt is the keyword. Crypt, here we are having the options for crypt, what possible encryption techniques we can use. Crypt, DES, MD5, Glowfish. Okay, here we are having three options. We can use DES technique to vault. Encryption technique is Glowfish. So possibility program will encrypt the password by using Glowfish program. It will read the file /etc/default/possibility, and in this file we have crypt value and Glowfish. So possibility program will use Glowfish method to encrypt the password.
Which one is the stronger encryption, Glowfish, MD5 or DES? Which one of them?
Sir, right now currently I don't have a perfect idea for that. Which one is? But Suze Linux is using Glowfish, so it will be the
same one.
By default, it's Glowfish using Glowfish. Explain that Glowfish must be the better.
Could you tell me that where is the user information are kept? In which file the user information are kept?
EDC, password.